Hi everyone, and welcome again to a new video. Just a few days ago, Microsoft released their 2024 update for Windows 11, better known as 24H2. As you probably know if you're watching this video, Windows 11 comes with some specific hardware requirements, and in this video, I will show you how you can work around that if you want to upgrade your current Windows 10 install to the latest Windows 11 version. Windows 11, theoretically, requires your machine to support secure boot, have a TPM 2.0 module, and your CPU to be on the list of compatible models. Fortunately, it has been possible since the beginning to work around these limitations, and so far, unsupported hardware has been able to run Windows 11 without any issues. Performance is pretty good and similar to Windows 10, updates are working just fine, and all in all, everything works just as you would expect. What does require some action is that with each major update, as was the case last year for 23H2, the year before for 22H2, and now as well with the latest version 24H2, the methods you can use to skip the hardware checks during installation or while upgrading do change a bit. For each of these in the past, I have been documenting a new workaround, and this video is no difference to that. As there are multiple possible scenarios to get Windows 11 24H2 on your unsupported machine, depending on your starting point, I decided to publish three separate videos covering each of these. This video is about upgrading an existing Windows 10 installation directly to the latest 24H2 version of Windows 11. If you have unsupported hardware and you are already on an earlier version of Windows 11, like 23H2, 22H2, or even older, you can use the video for which I'll put a card here now instead. And if you're looking how to do a fresh installation of Windows 11 24H2 on your unsupported hardware, you can use the one that appears here now. So, for this video, I'll be using my Dell Optiplex 9020, which I also used in the past to test and play around with Windows 11 extensively. Currently, I have Windows 10 installed on it, and as you can see, it is equipped with a 4th generation Intel Core i5 CPU, which is not supported. The version of Windows 10 that is currently on here is the Home Edition. As you can also see here, my installation has been activated with Microsoft, and the idea is that we keep it that way. If we go to Windows Update, we can see that I have all available updates installed, and there is a message here indicating that I can check compatibility for Windows 11. We already know that this won't pass, but let's download that PC Health Check app which is mentioned here quickly to double check. Over here, we get reminded once more to the requirements for Windows 11, but let's proceed by downloading that app. Once downloaded, I can install it and then start it. And as expected, officially, Windows 11 cannot run on this machine as it doesn't meet the TPM 2.0 requirement, and as I mentioned before, I have an unsupported processor. One thing that I do need to mention here that is really different from the previous version is that in this version 24H2, Microsoft started to rely on a specific SSE 4.2 CPU instruction called POPCNT. In other words, this is a real hardware limitation, so CPUs that do not have this instruction built in will not be able to run 24H2, and the bad news is that if you would have such a CPU, your system will no longer be able to boot after upgrading. The good news is that your CPU needs to be over 15 years old for this to be the case. For Intel CPUs, for example, anything that is an Intel Core CPU or newer, which was introduced back in 2008 already, or for AMD, about everything that got released after the same year, does have support for that instruction. So, unless you have a really, really old CPU, you should be fine. So, let's go ahead now and work around these limitations and upgrade this Windows 10 home installation to the latest Windows 11 24H2. This will work in exactly the same way for Windows 10 Professional, of course, but I just want to mention it. To start, we need to get the Windows 11 ISO from Microsoft. So let's open our browser and navigate to the download page for Windows 11. As you can see, there are several options available. You could download the ISO directly over here, but I recommend to do this instead by using the Media Creation tool. The reason is that this tool will automatically detect the language of your original installation and download the same version. If there would be a mismatch, even if the display language is seemingly fine, you could end up in a situation where you can't upgrade and keep your files. Once the tool is downloaded, let's start it from our downloads folder. And accept the license terms. Here we can see that the language is automatically detected, which is good, so we can leave this use recommended options for this PC. Then choose to download just the ISO file, click Next, and choose where the tool should put the file. I'll put it in my downloads folder as well and call it Windows 11 24H2. After this, the media creation tool will download the required files, and the ISO will eventually be created where you told it to. There we are. We should be able to find the ISO now in our downloads folder, so let's open that. Now, we need to mount that ISO. You can do that by simply right-clicking on the file and then choose Mount. This creates a new drive letter, which in my case is the letter E, as you can see here as well. This is like a virtual DVD drive, which has the necessary installation files in it. Now, to work around the hardware checks, we will need to launch the setup program with a special argument. This is a method that was working for earlier versions before as well, but now the alternative option, where you would remove the contents of a file called upraiser-res.dll, is no longer working for 24H2. In order for us to continue with the upgrade now, we need to start the command prompt. So press Start, type CMD, and press Enter. In here, we need to switch to that mounted ISO's drive letter. In my case, that was drive letter E, so I need to type E colon and press Enter. Obviously, if you have a different letter, that is what you will need to use here. By using the dir command, we can do an extra verification that we have the correct drive letter, as we can see the same files as on that mounted ISO over here. Next, we will need to start setup.exe and add that argument that I mentioned. So let's type setup/product/server and press Enter. This will launch the in-place upgrade. And as you can see, it mentions here that it will install Windows Server. Don't worry about that, as it will just upgrade the currently installed Windows edition, which is Home in my case, but this will bypass the hardware checks. Here, make sure to click Change How Setup Downloads Updates, and then select Not Right Now. Click Next. Accept the license terms, and choose Keep Files, Settings, and Apps to keep everything in the way it is and upgrade the currently installed Windows 10 operating system to Windows 11 24H2. Finally, in here, we get a confirmation that we will just upgrade to Windows 11 Home, in case you would still be worried about that, and then let's click Install to begin the process. At this point, your operating system is getting upgraded to Windows 11, and you will need to be a bit patient. If all goes well, you should eventually end up to your desktop, but this time, it is on Windows 11 24H2. For me, this process took about 70 minutes, which I think is pretty fast seeing the old hardware I have. That's it, our Windows 10 installation has been upgraded. So let's verify that. In System About, we can see that I'm still on that same unsupported hardware, but now we have Windows 11 Home 24H2 on here, just like we wanted. In terms of activation, my machine is also still activated, so that whole /product/server thing did not mess up anything. And to double check, let's see if we can find some of the changes that were introduced in this new release. The quick settings, for example, now has pages. And in File Explorer, if we try to compress a file, we can now choose from multiple formats. Those are just a few small examples of the changes. But more importantly, this shows, as you could see, that we successfully upgraded our Windows 10 installation to the latest and greatest Windows 11 version on this unsupported hardware. That was all I had for the video. I hope this will help you to extend the life of your machine. If you have liked this video, I would appreciate a thumbs up. Let me know how this worked for you in the comments or if you have any questions. And make sure to subscribe if you like these kind of videos. Thanks again and hope to see you back here soon.